Hello, everybody. Today I am going to elaborate about this hydraulic training kit. First, I show you the 12 components present in this portable hydraulic training kit. So this is one number of double acting cylinder. This is double acting cylinder. Then this is also a double acting cylinder. Two numbers of double acting cylinder in this kit, and one sequence valve, one 4x2 directional control valve. This one, this is 4x3 directional control valve, and this is check valve, relief valve, pressure reducing valve, one hydraulic motor, one air declaration check valve. This is drain block, and this is pressure block. Okay, pressure from hydraulic pump. Finally, we get output from here by this distribution block. Okay, in this system, hydraulic pump here, gear type hydraulic pump. This is hydraulic tank. This hydraulic tank pressure. Finally, we get output by this back side of this training kit. One pipe is connected to this distribution block. We can get final pressure by this distribution block. Okay. These are the hydraulic hoses that can be connected by these plugs. Okay. These fittings. Okay. Now I can going to show you one actuating a deep double acting cylinder by using 4x3 directional control valve. Okay. Now this is a pressure line from compressor. This is two speed connected process. So like this, you can like press it and push it. Like this, you can connect. Now we going to use this 4x3 directional control valve. So this pressure line is connected to here. One P mark is here. Like this, we connect. So one hose is connect here. And take another. This line is drain line, means hydraulic after doing some work, hydraulic going to drain from here to go into this distribution block. This is collecting tank, collecting to tank line. Now connect it to the double acting cylinder. One more required. Now, if you think make a hydraulic circuit, need to connect the relief valve, because if you not connect the relief valve in a hydraulic circuit, hydraulic coil may burst. Okay, so you need to connect the relief valve to this circuit. So connecting relief valve, you take another pressure line from here, and this is relief valve. The input of this relief valve. Okay, connected. Now from this relief valve, one draining hose will be required. Finally, connected to tank, return tank distribution block. Okay. Now this circuit is complete. here you can see from first, this is the first line, power line coming from pump connecting to the 4x2 directional control valve, and one line, this line connecting to the drain return to tank distribution block, okay. And another two, these are the outlet of this 4x3 directional control valve, one connected to here and another here, okay. Now circuit is complete, and another line, this is for relief valve to preventing the circuit from bursting of hydraulic pipe or maintain a hydraulic pressure at a certain level, okay. Now we can run the hydraulic motor by using here. Now hydraulic pump is running function. By this lever we can actuate, this double acting cylinder. One question arrives, why it is called 4x3 directional control valve? You can observe from here, this keeping this position of this lever is a neutral position. This is position, you can assume this is position 1, then this is position 2, then 3. So it is called 4x3. Now going to explain to you the next experiment of hydraulic trainer. Here, last experiment we are using a 4x3 directional control valve, this directional control valve. Now we use a 4x2 directional control valve. This is 4x3, this is 4x2. Now we are going to find out the, what is the difference between 4x3 and 4x2 directional control valve, actuating a double acting cylinder. So these are the connections I already done here. So this is first connection, this is a pressure line which was connected to pressure line here, okay. This one, and one more here which is the drain line draining to hydraulic drain, and these are the two hoses connected to the hydraulic cylinder, okay. This is the connections, and one more is already connected, one more connections for the relief valve to relieve the excess pressure, to prevent the bursting of pipe and maintain a hydraulic pressure at a certain level. Okay. Now we are going to switch on. Now by actuating this lever, now you see what happens. This position cylinder is extending. After relieving, it is automatically come inside. Again, take it to this position, then it will extend it. If you left it, it automatically comes to reverse direction. Means this control valve have only two directions. This one extending, and after extending, it will come to the back direction automatically. Means two directions. Last 4x3 was happened. One neutral positions are there in the mid of this lever, but here no neutral position. So this is called 4x2 directional control valve. Like this we can perform various type of experiment by using this hydraulic training kit. I show you the two numbers, two experiments on this training kit. Like this, you can use a sequence valve operation also, another sec valve, and hydraulic motors are there, pressure reducing valves are there, various valves are there. You can do various type of experiment and to the, get the practical knowledge about hydraulic, how actually hydraulic working principle, and how this hydraulic is a machine actually working by this type of using this type of control valves and other components. Okay, so this is the finally done, and one more thing, to using this one reliever actually needing to need to connect the circuit, complete the circuit by using here, but one more relief valve is required to maintain a pressure. That relief valve is nearby this hydraulic pump. By this relief valve, this pump actually make the hydraulic pressure at a certain level. After this, we get the output from this distribution block, and we can finally do the work. And another relief valve is connected in the circuit, in the mid of the circuit, to prevent the here a fluctuation pressure may be occurred due to this directional control valve. So this will be prevented by this relief valve. Okay. So this is the things of a hydraulic trainer kit using in our lab. So thank you.